Hey everyone, welcome to Simplilearn's YouTube channel. In this session, we will learn everything about JMeter Script Recording. JMeter is one of the most preferred software testing tools today. It is an open source, purely Java-based software that is used for load testing and performance testing. Initially, JMeter was developed to test applications, but now has expanded to other functions as well. In this video, we shall learn about the most exceptional feature of JMeter, that is, the script recording. First, let's have a look at the agenda for today's session. The first topic that we will cover is what is script testing, where we will understand the basics of script recording and its relevance. After that, we shall see the prerequisites of JMeter script recording. And finally, we shall see a hands-on demo to understand the process of script recording in JMeter. But before we begin, make sure that you have subscribed to our YouTube channel and click that bell icon to never miss an update from Simplilearn. So, without any further ado, let's get started with what is script recording. Record testing in JMeter helps testers to record and run their activity against test targets. It is a type of automated testing, but for multiple users, the test script is designed to record such scenarios. The proxy server allows JMeter to watch and record user activity while browsing web applications with a normal web browser. When we talk about proxy, it is a component that is present between you and the remote server. Let us say that you want to record web browser interactions when JMeter starts acting like a proxy. This is when JMeter script recording is used. Script recording is one of the advanced and impressive ways to figure out and eliminate the complexity of browser interactions in software testing. Now when we know what script recording is and how it is relevant, let's look into how to do it in JMeter. But before that, let's check the prerequisites of script recording in JMeter. There are three major prerequisites. First is having JMeter installed in your system. The second requirement is having Java installed in your system. The third and final requirement is having Mozilla Firefox in your system.
Now, let us have a look at the hands-on demo of how to perform script recording in JMeter. So, the first step is we shall go to the Apache JMeter folder. In that folder, we will go into bin folder and then select the jmeter.bat folder. Let us double click on that. This might take a while. And then the JMeter window will open on the screen. The home window is divided into two sections. On the left side, all the test plan elements are added. And on the right side, all the configurations of the elements are added. As we are on the test plan element, we can see the configurations of the same. Here, you can think of the test plan like a place or a container where all the elements we will be using to perform this test will be stored. All the requests, all the listeners, and everything will be stored here. Now, the first step is to add thread group. So for that, right-click on the thread group. Select Add, and from Add, go to Threads or Users, and in that, select thread group. Here, the thread group refers to the users. It has several different options, like the action to be taken after there is an error. You can choose it the way you want. Then, there is this number of threads where you can choose the number of users you want. Then, there is a ramp-up period and second option that states the time gap between the user hits. Third, there is a loop count where you can choose how many number of times the test will run for a number of users. You can also choose the test to run for infinite times. There is also a scheduler here to help you schedule the start time and the test's end time. The next step is to add an HTTP request. For that, right-click on the thread group. Go to the Add option and now go to the Sampler option. Select the HTTP request option. Here, there is a server name or IP box. We have to give the server name or IP in that. Let us pick a website and place the link in the box. We shall use the Simplilearn's website here. Go to Simplilearn's website and copy the URL from here. Then come back to the JMeter window and paste it in the server name box. Keep in mind that we don't need to give HTTP or HTTPS since these are protocols that will come in the other box and they will be automatically taken in the HTTP request case. Then in the path dialog box, we will leave a forward slash there since we have to access the root page. Now the next step is to add the HTTP test script recorder. For that, right click on the test plan, then go to non-test elements and select the HTTP test script recorder option. The window on the screen shows several options. Here, we can see the start option to begin the test. Then, there is a box that has the port number. You can make this number whatever you like. I'll put this number as 1234 for now. Then let's go back to the SimpliLearn's website and go to the resources page. Then come back to the JMeter's window and rename the recording controller as resources. Now let us add another recording controller so that JMeter works like a proxy with the help of HTTPS test script recorder. Then again, go back to the resources page that we just opened and scroll down a little bit. Here, we can see several technologies and several other links. In those links, you can select any one of the links. I will select digital marketing here. Then go back to the JMeter window and rename the recording controller as digital marketing. Then finally, let's add a recording controller for the home page and rename it as SimpliLearn's home page. So now we can see that we have a thread group here. Then there is a HTTP request where we have SimpliLearn website in the server name. Then there are three recording controllers, one for the resources, the second for digital marketing, and a third one for homepage. And last we have a HTTP test script recorder. Here, I will rearrange the recording controllers in sequence, putting the SimpliLearn's homepage controller on the top and then placing the resources, finally digital marketing recording controller. Now, let us open Mozilla Firefox in our system. Go to the general option here and scroll down to the network settings. In the network settings option, select settings. In the window that appears, select the manual proxy configuration. Here, we shall put the port number. For now, I will put the port number as 1234 in this box. Here in the HTTP proxy, we have localhost and we have selected to use this proxy for FTP and HTTPS and then click on OK. Now go back to the Apache JMeter folder and now we shall use this Apache JMeter temporary root CA file, which is a security certificate file. So coming back to the Mozilla Firefox window, go to the options tab and in this tab, I will type certificates and here we shall select view certificates. In the window that opens, let us import the security certificate from JMeter folder. Here we shall select these two boxes so that the proxy server can access the website that we shall enter here in the browser and then select OK. Coming back to the JMeter window, let us add some listeners to get the results. Listeners are something that are used to provide the outputs of a test. There are different types of listeners present in JMeter and many may be added using plugins. For adding listeners, right-click on HTTP test script recorder. For adding listeners, right-click on the HTTP test script recorder. Then go to add option and then go to listeners option and then add view results tree. Now let us add one more listener in the same way. We shall add view results in tree. Now in the HTTP test script recorder in the target controller option, save the target controller. Here in the drop-down, select the SimpliLearn homepage option as we will begin the script recording for the homepage. Finally, let's start the test by clicking here. Click on OK. Now go back to the Mozilla browser and here let us open the SimpliLearn's homepage. Now come back to the JMeter window, go to the homepage recording controller. You can see the homepage controller has started. As you can see, the homepage controller has started recording the scripts that are being performed. These are the tasks that are performed on the client side to the server side. Now we can check both the listeners that we have put to see what all functions are working fine and what all are not. All the tasks from the time that we have entered to simplilearn.com in our browser are recorded in this homepage controller. To take the test further, go to the test script recorder and stop the test. Now here in the target controller, select the second controller, that is the resources controller. Now start the test again. Select OK. Go to SimpliLearn's website, select resources. After opening the resources link, go back to the JMeter window. And now in the resources controller, you can see what all events are recorded from the client side to the server side. Once we click on the resources link, now again in the two listeners, you can check all the scripts and tests are successful or have failed. Now for our last recording controller, go back to the test script recorder and stop the test. Now here in the target controller, select the third option, that is the digital marketing. Now here in the target controller, select the third option, that is digital marketing. Start the test and select OK. Now get back to the Mozilla Firefox window, go to resources, go to digital marketing. After digital marketing link has opened, go back to the JMeter window. And now in the digital marketing controller, you can see what all events are recorded from the client side to the server side. Once we click on that link, I guess this is taking a while. You can see all steps coming under the recording controller and then you can also see the two listeners, some of the tests are being successful and some are not. We can sum this entire process as a way of communicating between the server and the client with a proxy server help. In this case, the proxy server is our JMeter. That is why it was able to record all the steps that are happening while we were performing any task. This is how we can perform the JMeter script testing in few simple steps. Now, when you are done with the proxy server, do not forget to go back to your browser and change your network settings back to normal. That is, go to the settings, select use system proxy settings, and that's how it is done. So guys, this was all for today's session. Hope you guys found it informative and helpful. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more from Simplilearn.
Hi there. If you like this video, subscribe to the Simplilearn YouTube channel and click here to watch similar videos. To nerd up and get certified, click here.